The familiar constellation of Orion includes giant stars whose surfaces are so hot they can be seen brightly in visible light, the only light humans can detect with the unaided eye. Other bright areas of Orion include some nebulae, which are clouds of gas and dust whose atoms have been energized enough to also give off optical light. The most famous of these is the Great Orion Nebula. Beyond these few visible markers, Orion, like all constellations, resembles a connect the stars around a lot of empty space. However, in other kinds of light, the region of Orion is not like other constellations. It reveals itself to be bursting with invisible material. We aim our infrared and radio telescopes into the dusty, dark places, because the darker they appear to optical telescopes, the brighter they will appear in infrared and radio. Here is Orion in infrared light, a type of invisible light we personally know as heat. What a difference. The infrared light in Orion is given off by dust particles wiggling in this very busy region of our galaxy. Dust gathers at the locations of star and planet construction and deconstruction, so it is a great tracer of hidden activity. In radio light, Orion shows giant river-like structures that trace the filaments of dense gas and molecules coming together to make stars and planets deep inside dust envelopes. Bright cores mark solar system-forming regions, whereas bright rings mark the scars of ancient supernova explosions.